Good day to Dinarans on the go and in the know, October 22, 2019, no hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest, Iraqi Ministry of Finance announces good news in 2020 budget, October 23, 2019 6:40:46. The Ministry of Finance disclosed that the budget law for next year, which has achieved advanced stages of discussion, has not adopted a fixed price per barrel of oil so far, and the daily export of 3,800,000 barrels, the share of the Kurdistan region of which 250,000 barrels, confirming the keenness of all parties to adopt the next budget, provide services, compensation and salaries to citizens to contribute to improving the living and economic conditions of the country. The semi-official newspaper quoted the Undersecretary of the Ministry Dr. Mayor Hamad Yohan as saying that the budget for next year 2020 will be unconventional, as it relied mainly on the provision of services and the needs of citizens across the country, stressing that it is under study and will last between 4 to 5 stages to reach its final destination, noting that its basic idea depends on how to provide the necessary funding to meet the needs of citizens and compensation and salaries. In addition to the success of the government program of the state, he added that the budget law for the next year has not yet adopted a fixed price for Iraqi oil exporter, but there are proposals submitted adopt a price ranging from $50 to $56 per barrel, including oil allocated from the Kurdistan region of Iraq and 250,000 barrels per day, indicating that the financial budgets, each of them a certain specificity, and therefore the House of Representatives may put any other amendment to modify the direction of the share of the Kurdistan region of oil produced there, or any amendment, another in its code. On the mechanism of filling the deficit in the current budget 2019, Yohan disclosed that part of it was addressed through loans in the original budget, the other part was through the cash already available in the Ministry of Finance, while part of the deficit will remain until the end of this year, will be on account for reducing expenditures on everyone, noting that the fiscal deficit for next year budget is unclear. Landmarks yet, he promised government banks in the country, one of the tools of the state to solve any financial forms, whether to pay the deficit or even revitalize the economic movement in the country, but its potential remains limited by the amount of funds available to them, pointing out that the state has used a large part of it during the past years, indicating given the situation in the country, any amount offered by banks to the state transparently will be part of the country's ongoing economic reform and growth. Next article of interest. Highlights of Abdul Mahdi's speech to the people tomorrow expanded. Baghdad, October 23, 2019 17:05. Iraqi Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi said on Wednesday that he will address a speech to the Iraqi people on Thursday on urgent steps and reform measures. The following are the most important steps and urgent reform measures, according to the statement of the Information Office of Abdul Mahdi. 1. If we hold the sessions of the House of Representatives next week, ministerial amendments away from the concepts of quotas and focus on competencies and the independence of ministers and the increasing presence of young people. 2. The government emphasizes the importance of the Supreme Judicial Council to form the central court for combating corruption to hold corrupt persons accountable, and open corruption files clearly and in front of the public opinion, especially those that affect the theft of funds for vital projects such as hospitals, schools, streets, bridges, dams and other basic projects to accommodate more jobs, especially for the poor. Working hard with the legislature to enact a law where do you get this includes senior officials, with an emphasis on the importance of localization of salaries and encircling transactions in paper currency and paper transactions, which helps to expose the inflation of the funds of many officials and enable justice to pursue them. 3. Reducing the salaries of officials up to the fourth degree of presidencies, ministers, members of the House of Representatives, special grades, agents and managers to reach in the high cases by half so that the highest salary and allocations do not exceed 10 million dinars per month, and to include a decline at the appropriate rates in line with the salary scale of the fifth degree and below, and raise the minimum salary. 4. Allocation of funds derived from the reduction of salaries in addition to the state contribution to the establishment of a social security fund to ensure that no Iraqi remains below the poverty line, and that any Iraqi who has no income or any member of a family without income to receive a monthly grant of not less than 130,000 dinars, and provides the Council of Ministers to achieve this draft law, which began drafting as soon as the House of Representatives for approval. 5. The preservation of the country's sovereignty comes from respect for the rights and freedoms of the people, as well as the development of its own capabilities to maintain its security and sovereignty and continue to fight terrorism and ISIS. The government has confirmed that it has not granted permission for U.S. forces withdrawing from Syrian territory to remain in Iraqi territory, as reported by some media. We have issued an official statement and we are taking all international legal measures and demanding the international community and the United Nations to play their role in this regard. Any presence of foreign forces must be approved by the Iraqi government and terminated if requested by the Iraqi government is over. Next article of interest. Abdulmahdi receives U.S. Secretary of Defense. Politics, October 23, 2019, 1411, 310 Baghdad. Iraq Prime Minister Adel Abdulmahdi received on Wednesday, October 23, 2019, U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Esper. Adel Abdulmahdi received U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Esper, the Prime Minister's media office said. The U.S. Defense Secretary, Mark Esper, arrived Wednesday, October 23, 2019, the capital Baghdad, on a secret visit. A source told Baghdad Today that Esper arrived in the early hours of this morning to Baghdad an unannounced visit, noting that the U.S. Secretary is scheduled to discuss with his Iraqi counterpart to transfer his country's troops from Syria and keep them in Iraq, in addition to the fight against ISIS. The U.S. Secretary made a secret visit to Saudi Arabia on Monday, October 21, 2019, to discuss the two countries' shared concerns as tensions with Iran escalate during a Middle East tour. According to Saudi media, Esper held talks with King Salman bin Abdulaziz and his crown prince. U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Esper said Sunday, October 20, 2019, that 1,000 troops withdrawn from Syria were expected to go to western Iraq. The forces in western Iraq will focus on helping to defend Iraq and fight ISIS, he said. According to Reuters, the ceasefire in northeastern Syria is generally coherent. It is expected that all the troops withdrawing from northern Syria, which number about 1,000 troops, to western Iraq, to continue the campaign against ISIS fighters and to help defend Iraq. The U.S. withdrawal is well underway from northeastern Syria, Asper told reporters on his way to the Middle East. We are talking about weeks, not days. There are about 1,000 people, he said. Next article of interest. Iraq contradicts Pentagon, says U.S. forces not approved to stay, by Rachel Frazin. October 22, 1907, 26 a.m. EDT. Iraq's military said Tuesday that U.S. troops that entered the country after withdrawing from Syria can't remain there. All U.S. forces that withdrew from Syria received approval to enter the Kurdistan region so that they may be transported outside Iraq. There is no permission granted for these forces to stay inside Iraq, the Iraqi military said in a statement. According to Reuters, the statement contradicts the Defense Department's announcement that many of the almost 1,000 departing U.S. troops were slated to go to Iraq to fight ISIS and help defend Iraq. A senior Pentagon official told Reuters that the plans could change. Critics say President Trump's decision to remove U.S. forces from northern Syria opened the door to a Turkish offensive against Syrian Kurds in the region. A ceasefire between Turkey and the Kurds, which aided the U.S. in the fight against ISIS, is expected to end on Tuesday. The president, however, has repeatedly stated that he hopes to get the U.S. out of endless wars and bring troops home. More than 5,000 U.S. troops are already in Iraq, according to Reuters. The Hill has reached out to the Pentagon for comment. Next article of interest. Iraqi inquiry says 157 people killed in anti-government protests. October 22, 2019, 12:59 Greenwich Mean Time. A total of 157 people were killed in recent anti-government protests in Baghdad and other Iraqi cities, an official investigation has found. The findings published on October 22 by the committee tasked with investigating the violence said that 149 civilians and 8 members of the security forces were killed in the mass protests, with the capital accounting for 111 of the dead. Demonstrators took to the streets of Iraqi cities during the week starting October 1 to protest high unemployment, poor public services, and widespread corruption in the country's worst violence since an Islamic State IS insurgency was largely defeated in 2017. The inquiry found that around 70% of the deaths were caused by bullet wounds to the head or chest. There was also evidence of sniper fire targeting protesters from atop a building in central Baghdad, it said. In its report, the investigative panel recommended that the Baghdad operations commander in charge of the response to the unrest and dozens of other senior security officials be dismissed. Officers and commanders lost control over their forces during the protests and this caused chaos, it said. As Iraq braces for new anti-government protests planned on October 25. Next article of interest, finance. Next year's budget focuses on the standard of living of the citizen. Baghdad Tariq Raji, Wednesday, October 23, 2019. The Ministry of Finance announced that the budget law for next year, which has achieved advanced stages in its discussion, in which the ministry did not adopt a fixed price of a barrel of oil so far, and by the daily export of 3,800,000 barrels, the share of the region of 250,000 barrels, confirming the keenness of all parties that the next budget includes providing services, compensation and salaries to citizens to contribute to improving the living and economic conditions of the country. Undersecretary of the Ministry Dr. Mayor Hamad Johan told Al Sabah that the financial budget for next year 2020 will be unconventional, as it relied mainly on providing services and the needs of citizens throughout the country, stressing that it is under study and will last between 4 to 5 phases to reach the final destination, noting that the basic idea depends on how to provide the necessary funding to meet the needs of citizens and compensation and salaries. In addition to the success of the government program of the state, next article of interest, Iraqi parliamentary delegation meets IBBC, October 23, 2019 by John Lee. An Iraqi parliamentary delegation headed by Dr. Bashir Khalil al-Haddad met in London last week with Baroness Emma Nicholson, president of the Iraq-Britain Business Council IBBC. In discussion with members of the council, they exchanged views on the expansion of foreign investment in Iraq, as well as further cooperation between Iraqi and British private sector companies. Source, Iraqi Parliament. Next article of interest, Minister Abdulmahdi refuses to resign and considers it an escape from responsibility. October 23, 2019, 6:53 Baghdad. Prime Minister Adel Abdulmahdi will not resign, Housing and Housing Minister Benkin Rikani said Wednesday, noting that Abdulmahdi considered the resignation as an escape from responsibility. Prime Minister Adel Abdulmahdi will not resign, Rikani said in a press statement, quoted by the official Iraqi news agency INA. He added that the government has fulfilled most of the promises made and the rest of them will be implemented soon. It is expected that the demonstrations peaceful called by youth activists through social networking sites in Baghdad and the provinces, on Friday, 25 October, which is an extension of the demonstrations of the first of this month, political forces are demanding the current government headed by Abdulmahdi to resign and form a rescue government, while others believe that resignation is not a solution to overcome the crisis in the country, warning of dragging the country to the unknown. Next article of interest. SADR put forward 15 proposals for demonstrators next Friday. Wave of the people is coming. October 23, 2019, 2058 Baghdad Today Baghdad. Bikada al-SADR, the leader of the Sadrist movement, on Wednesday, presented 15 proposals to the demonstrators on Friday, while assuring the protesters that in the event of assault on you again, we will act in a way that suits the satisfaction of God and satisfaction. I promised God that I would not be the backbone of the corrupt, but as my father taught me to be a supporter of the reformers, SADR said in a statement obtained by Baghdad Today. In his statement, al-SADR mentioned 15 points that were singled out by the demonstrators as follows. First point, give your brother in the security forces a rose. The second point, the spirit of perseverance and patience for the homeland, love the country of faith. The third point, to preserve the property of the public and private people, understand your brothers. The third point, that the good does not target the guilt of the corrupt in the government who are overwhelmed, do not hurt them. Point 4, reflect a beautiful picture of your organization and your chairs, your actions and your actions. Fifth point, do not start violence, corrupt is not afraid of arms more than peace. Sixth point, many people, even those who belong to the parties who are not in the government, want to participate, but it is ignorant of your demands and your mechanisms. Point 7, keep yourself as much as possible. Point 8, Do not allow anyone to confiscate your efforts to those at home and abroad. You are the owners of the initiative. Point 9. Your brothers in the Sadrus all formations at your service. We ask God that you do not need the help of anyone. Point 10. Raising the level of your demands is a good condition on the prudence in order not to lose Iraq constitutionally and security. Please pay attention. Point Zai. Document and pictures what happens as much as possible. Point 12. Your reputation is more important than your demands. Point 13. I advise in coordination with the Iraqi tribes and cultural, literary and media elites and others. Point 14. The patience of the corrupt quickly run out and your patience longer of tashu rope of God and do not despair of Slametkum greater than their walls and their weapons. Finally, know that if you are assaulted again, we will act in a way that suits the satisfaction of God. The leader of the Sadrist movement said, the wave of the people is coming through the shore of the bow and you corrupt bend. More articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.